Good afternoon. We are here with continuing with the forensic medicine competency number 3.2, identification. In all medico-legal work, all medico-legal cases, identification remains at the top of the priority. Whether it could be the live patient coming to your casualty in your hospital, in your nursing home, or could it be a dead body, skeletonized body brought for the medico-legal autopsy? Identification is the main objective of performing the medico-legal case and its examination. So we are here to continue with the competency. Identification, you know, is nothing but the individuality of an individual. You are determining the individuality by its character, by its features, by its various parameters. You confirm that the particular individual is this one. Either it could be the absolute, you are confirming the identity 100%, it means absolute, or it could be incomplete or partial one, where you are not ascertaining whether the individual is the same or not. In living, why it is important? Because sometimes it could be the absconding soldiers, criminals, or accused of rape, as this is the topic for discussion today, or accused of any assault case or sodomy case or murder case, or mixing of the babies in hospital, or young lost children and adults who have lost their memories. In these such conditions, we are supposed to ascertain their identity by means of various features. As I said, you have already learned many other features, but also you are supposed to see the what are the other features. This is also in disputed sex or victims of a criminal cases, and in this condition it must be identified with the investigating agency before starting the investigation itself. This should be started in cases of criminal abortion also. Who is the lady who actually aborted? Any product of conception has to be confirmed. Also to fix the age of the criminal and their responsibilities according to their majority of age. In civil cases, the fraudulent personation matters. There the identity plays the important role, such as unlawful possession of the property. The person is not the owner, but he is possessing it. So to fix the identity in such civil cases also, sometimes the role of medico-legal kind of examination confirming the identity matters. Then insurance cases and obtain the prolongation of the lapsed pension. These are the certain things. In addition to that, these are the situations, not only in the live cases, but in cases of the dead also, we are also supposed to confirm the identity of the individual. In cases of mass disasters, in cases of the fragmentary remains, mutilated body, skeletonized body, or unknown bodies, decomposed bodies, or only skeletons are brought. So in such cases also identity has to be confirmed. What are the various features which can be included to ascertain the individuality of the individual, to confirm the identification, are nothing but the body features. These are nothing but the race, religion, age, sex, stature, complexion, then the congenital features, how personally he is appearing, physical characters. In addition to that, the today's topic is related with anthropometric various measurements, dactylography, poroscopy, footprints, malformations like birthmarks and moles. And in addition to that, there are some acquired peculiarities. What does it mean? During the life, itself, the because of occupational or because of his practices, he has got certain body features acquainted, or he is adopted to, he actually adopted those changes in the body. So those are occupational marks or tattoo marks or scars, sometimes malformation or deformities will also be seen. There are certain miscellaneous data in which you includes the handwriting, its speech, its gait, and also some obliteration of the identity sometimes may appear, and in that condition one has to confirm the identity. So one mnemonics I want to bring it for you for the medico-legal importance of sex. And what are the medico-legal importances of sex? Are nothing but, you can remember these two mnemonics. One is Mahendra Singh Dhoni never insisted Raina to marry prior election committee report. Or you can remember Mahendra Singh Dhoni newly included Raina in married popular elegant couple recently. What is this M stands for? Marriage. Because age for marriage for girls is 21 year, while for males it is 18 years. Divorce, D for divorce. There are certain grounds only on the basis of which the divorce can be asked. Yan for nullity of marriage. When the, as per Hindu Marriage Act, which contract of the marriage stands nullified will be told according to the importance, according to the non-consummation of marriage. I stands for inheritance, where the inheritance will go to the further level of the individuals. R, rape. The statutory age defines whether the accused is only above the age of adult or not. P stand for paternity. M also stand for maternity, whether the mother belonging the particular child or not. Paternity, who is the father of the child. Elections, E is standing for employment. You know, until and unless person is not actually attended the majority, he is not supposed to work in heavy work industries. So minimum 14 years of age or above 18 year is must. And C for the contesting the election, R for the civil rights. So likewise, these two mnemonics you can remember. See, there are certain religions in which you can identify if the person is being brought who has already lost the memory and is not remembering anything. From these other features you can conclude the identity. Some tattoos, in cases of male, the shendi, you know, tuft of the hair, the scarce thread around the neck, or some holy stones, talismans in the right arm, presence of wooden bead necklace, or presence of vertical mark of vermini on the forehead for the Hindu males. For Hindu females also, vermini in a married woman with a living husband, and conch shell bangles will be there, mangal sutras will be there, nose pricking, ear prickings will be there, that can be identified. In Muslim males, tattoos won't be there, but the callosity or forehead will give you some clues that the person is regularly praying for the namaz. Presence of tuft of beard around the chin, and mehndi scented hair sometimes. The circumcision will be there. Square talismans around the neck. Tight, what you know. The female will have this kind of burqas coverings, and those mark can easily be seen here. In general development, the height of the individual, that is stature, height, weight, general muscular development, this all comes under anthropometric measurement. Congenital features are also there. So those are nothing but the personal appearance, how it is, and there are certain additional like dactylography, poroscopy, fingerprinting, these are there. What is this anthropometrical findings or parameters? Anthropometry is nothing but the physical parameters and its study in details, which are very peculiar for individuals. So Bertillonage is the name given for the anthropometry. Usually those who were the habitual criminals, the registered was maintained in the Great Britain, and in 1882, in the 19th century, anthropometry was introduced by Alphonse Bertillon, who is known to be the founder of this anthropometry. And based on height, span arms, trunk length, and all body parameters are included here, he found that the ratios, their different parameters, their length measurements are very unique for every individual. And hence, in 1888, the Department of Judicial Identity was established there, and there is one in 4 million probability for getting the very similar findings for the two different individuals. So that's why anthropometry remains important in cases of the investigations. There are fingerprints, which is also identified as an important tool. And in 1820, Professor Johann Perkinghuis studied it, but after him, in 1860, William Herschel studied it further. Same period, Dr. Henry Faulds reported in 1880. It was the Galton, Francis Galton, published a paper on classification of fingerprints, but it took 1891 period, and Edward Henry had his simple classification, and in 1940, again Alphonse Bertillon died a shattered man. And see, what is this fingerprint? These are the nothing but the ridges on your palmar surface. See how the ridges took the appearance, how the ridges took the appearance on the palms, the fingers, how it looks like. If it is taken on a paper, it looks like this. These features of the ridges are again very unique for every individual, and that's why fingerprint is one of the important tool in identification. See, these are the various ridges, and accordingly the numbers can be given for comparison purpose. Their dots, their various points are to be matched, whether they are continuous or whether they are interrupted one, whether they are bifurcated one, whether they has got a unique differences or distance between the two different ridges, or they are very close to. So likewise, various features are compared and matched whenever the suspected fingerprints are obtained from the scene of crime. What is dactylography or the fingerprint study or the dermatoglyphics? It is nothing but a process of taking impressions of the pulp of fingers and thumbs on an unglazed white paper and examining them with a magnifying lens. This can be obtained with some ink or powders, and then they are studied. Even if you hold some glass water or any metallic surface, your fingerprints will be reflecting or getting stored on those surfaces. It is because your hands are having the sebaceous secretion, sebum secretion, the sweat secretions which get deposited there, and very minutely you can study those prints. The principle is that fingers covers with characteristic ridges, and those are permanent and unique for every individual. It is said that even the univovular twins has got the different fingerprints. And Locard's principle of exchange is the main theme of today's discussion. What is this? You have to identify either accused or criminal from their appearance, and one has to trace either of these. If the two bodies are coming together or coming close together, there is always exchange of material from one to another, and this will lead to sequence the scene of a crime, and this will also help in linking the traces, linking the connection in between of these two individuals if these two close contact are taking place in between the accused and the victim. Accused is the person who is actually committing actively the crime, and the sufferer is nothing but the survivor or the victim. So Locard was the France scientist who was known to be the Sherlock Holmes of France, and his principle is very well known in forensic. He said that whenever the two bodies comes together, those will lead to exchange of materials between them. So when two objects are coming in contact with each other, there will always be a mutual transfer of material from one to another. For dactylography, there are four basic fingerprints. One is loop, whorl, arch, composite, which is also called as mixed, which is of the less in number. The percentage of arch is next to that. The whorl is next to common, but the very commonly found characters or the fingerprint types is the loop. It is almost 65%. This will be asked as a MCQ or in Viva, it will be very routinely asked. Then what are these arches? Arches either are the plain arches or tented arches. When you see it, clarification with the diagrams. Then loops are either radial or ulnar, depending on the side from which the hand and the tail points it is indicating. Then composite, it has got a central pocket loop with or double loop and accidental finding. See, these are the arches. As I said, simple arch or tented arch. Tented means a tent is being formed in the center. What is arch? See, the loop is starting from one end. It is having some curvature there and ending on the other end. So starting point and the ending point is at two different sides, not on the same side. And that's why these are called as arch. It is forming some kind of arch in which, if it is taking such a character's shape, it is called as tented arch. If you see this loop, see, it is like this. It is discontinued here, and sometimes this is reuniting here. So characters, even you can see this bifurcated, again united at this. This is the loop where it is discontinuing, again it is there. So it has got some characters, and that are to be matched. See, here in this reach, it is getting bifurcated and it is getting united with the another one. So every reach has got very peculiar, though it is amongst the arch, it has got further characters of the each reach. So arches are nothing but the starting point and the ending point are at two different place, loop. See, it is starting from this side, it is taking this shape, and it is getting end on the same side. So likewise, it is taking the loop. So starting and ending point is on the same side. That's why it is a loop. Either it could be a right loop or left loop, depending on from which side it is taking, which form it is taking the loop. double loop. See, this is one loop and this is another loop. So two loops are getting mixed here. Whirl, as I said, the central one is the concentric kind of things you can see. These are the delta points. You can see these delta points and these are the whirls. So, and mixed, this is mixed one. Here no concentric but loop is also being seen. So mixed figure, and this is called as composite. How this comparison will be made? So this is the whether the triangle is there, central or pores, how many numbers are there, miniature of the ridges, like details of the ridge, whether it is indenting, bifurcating, spur formation, dots, legs, broken ridge, short ridge. So minimum 60 to 20 points of the fine comparisons are accepted towards the identification. How it is to be recorded will be dealt in practicals tomorrow in details. Two types, plain method, rolled method, and in criminals, this is the impression of all the digits of both hands are taken and preserved by the police for future identification. In dead bodies, the dried fingertips soaked in alkaline solution, if the skin peeled off dermis or peeled off skin is hardened by formalin. What is this plain method? Plain method, you have to dip the palmar surface on in the ink, then press it. You have to roll the complete surface of the finger in the ink, the finger printed on the paper. Here you can compare more. In plain method, your object will be discussed in details in the practicals tomorrow. Latent print are the characters in which and they have to work it. Plastic prints means those are obtained or present over the soft motion of blood or paint or dust, dye, which can be recorded by photography. If the accused or victim's fingerprint is stained with blood, paint, dust, dye, and then it is visible, then it is very peculiarly seen, and that's why it can be called as visible prints. Poroscopy, as I told you, on the surface of your fingers or the palms, there are the pores visible there. The similarly stained with mud can also be visualized, and that it has to be studied by means of his characters, whether it is imprinted fully or partly, what is the gesture, what is its gait, type of standing way. It helps in identification, and also it prints are taken, but the footprints are taken. The feet raises destructions, and that's why these are very helpful in the primary phase of the life. It is maintained by all Air Force flying personnel, because those are to be retained for their identification purpose. See, baby's footprint will be taken like this. See the ridges, how it looks like. Even the species can be known. Is it a human or animal footprint whenever any scene of crime is visited? So one has to know about this. There are also congenital malformations like N numbers of their cleft lip, hair lift, webbed fingers, or supernumerary fingers or toes. Dental peculiarities will be there, birthmark, moles will be there. See the characters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See the bifurcation here, additional 6 figure. So toes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can see the 6 toes. And accordingly, you can obtain the X-ray and can see the cleft palate. Identification, cleft lip and cleft palate, you can see. You may remember your anatomical or embryological lectures how these defects remains even after birth whenever there is failure of fusion of those lip. The occupation of the individuals like Goldsmith holding the pipe to blow the fire flame has got a very peculiar changes in the teeth. The gutka chewers, the people usually having the tobaccos regular or miseries will have the features. The implant in the tooth also will help in identification. The birthmark, hemangiomas are the various features. See this eye pupil color, the color of the hair will also helps you. Birthmarks will be helping you. The hairy appearance of and the darks and the hairy moles are additional features. So those are the acquired features. Occupational features or characters will also help in identification. Then the tattoo marks. Tattoo marks are nothing but the design effected by multiple small punctures wound made through the skin with needles or similar penetrating tools dipped in a dye. There are various kind of dye and those are having various colors. Those dye will get impregnated into dermis and accordingly it its appearance on the skin, and the designs will be very well noted. It remains forever until and unless you are manipulating it or removing it or by any alterations. How to describe the tattoo whenever you are attending medical legal examination of such individual or during medical legal autopsy, on which anatomical site it is present, what is the situation anatomically, size, what is its color, what design it is having, any letters are there, or whether it is the name of the god or design of the god or any photograph or sketch. Then either those could be the permanent dyes, black, red, blue, or depth of the penetration matters, whether it is only in the superficial or dermis, and which body part is tattooed. So high contrast photography, computer image enhancement, ultraviolet lamp, infrared photography is relevant. Tattoo marks can be made out. See, this kind of tattoos are nowadays very famous. It helps in identification. Sometimes own name will be there, name of the near or dear or spouse, relative, friends, date of birth, marriage, service will be mentioned. So likewise date will be there, sometimes name of the having the tattoos. The people are not living the any body tattoos. The people are not living the any body get it like this as per their religion, the locality. Even the criminals have got their gang name or very peculiar tattoo, or homosexuals will have got a bluebird on the finger webs, or sexually perverted individuals also has got various erotic kind of tattoo. The individuals can have n number of tattoos. The drug addicts will have got the tattoos and also has got the mucosal surfaces scarred. Socially, they are seen usually in earlier days in the low socio-economic strata, but nowadays it become a fashion. And even political convictions like various politicals signs will be tattooed, and previous tattoo marks can be effaced by means of silver nitrates, carbon dioxide, snow, electrolysis, and not permanent, then it can be removed. The excision can be done, surgical or cosmetical surgeries will be done to remove it. And in cases of eczema and some skin diseases also, it will be getting easily removed. How it is remaining permanent? See, the pigments inside the fixed microbe measures will be looks like this. So permanently it is getting fixed in the macrophages, and that's why it will be very, very visible. It is piercing the epidermis and dermis, and that's why it is making its permanent appearance. In decomposed bodies, the tattoo marks can be rendered visible and prominent by simple scraping of the superficial layer of the skin. And even if you study the nearby lymphatic nodes, lymph nodes will be getting the macrophages and the pigment components. And these are some scars. The dermabrasion and application of caustic substances, carbon dioxide, snow electrolysis, surgery, exposure to laser will give you the scar formation. And as I said, chronic eczema and confluent smallpox can remove the tattoo marks. Scars, it is nothing but a permanent critical mark which results from the healing of wound. And it actually is devoid of hair follicles, sweat glands, pigments and elastic fibers. It is covered with few layers of the simple epithelium and contains elastic tissue. It depends how the scar will be there. It depends on which kind of wound is the incised wound. See how sutures you can make their positions. See the scars, the injury, how this stapling is done. See the staples, you can see. See the injury and how it heals later on. There are some other injuries, burn injuries, some cross damages which can be healed like this. The acid attacks or the chemical injuries will be healing with the scars like this. Then stab wounds will be having elliptical scars, and punctured wounds will put the component of the bone has got changed into the different form, and it is very consistent with the finding of osteosarcoma. So if only bone is obtained, only skull is obtained, and you are getting the finding similar to osteosarcoma, you can suggest the identity of the individual suffering with such disease. Chemoscopy is nothing but the study of the lip print. Either it could be linear one, bifurcated, reticular or undermined. 24 individual characteristics it has got. Rugoscopy, it is nothing but the palatal rugies are studied and their patterns. So protected from the trauma because it is very well covered in the oral cavity, it has got its individual findings. Do not change during the growth. Harrison Allen was the first to talk about it in 1889. Primary rug, secondary rug and fragmented rugi he describes. Superimposition is another one. You have to have the some clue of the individual by means of photographs or its x-ray, and then for photos superimposition photographs are taken, and transparencies of skull photograph of the lifetime photograph are focused on the same sensitive printing paper. After maximum alignment, a positive print will be taken. Attempt is made to study the matching and non-matching of major anatomical landmarks. So two video superimposition is another technique in which two videos, one of photograph and another of skull, are mixed on the one video display unit. Negative matching is the skull is not that of the person in the photograph. Positive matching means the skull could be that of the person in the photograph. So by photographs or by means of videography, the two images are matched, they are superimposed. How the reconstruction will be done? Skull you have to obtain, then whether it is female or race or early 40s, then accordingly you have to confirm it. Note the unique features, whether had lost all back teeth and upper jaw, only these teeth are there. Anything know about the individual, so accordingly those can be obtained. Add tissues and depth. See, tissues are being added. Then based on largely on the sex and race, you know the muscles will be more powerful in the males than the females. Accordingly those will be keep adding. Begin to add common fat deposits and underlying muscles. Then you can have this kind of places to keep it. Add muscles to average depth for the race, and add skin, nose, ears. Add features related to age like wrinkles there, eyes, hair color, and then you can have your final clothings. You can add clothing, etc. appearance, so that you can have the maximum correlation if it is truly there. So see, likewise the reconstruction will be there. Superimposition can be found out. Yeah, this is photo superimposition. Those anatomical landmarks will be matched, and accordingly those will be confirmed. So this is what called as a superimposition. And different types of blood stains sometimes will be obtained at the scene of crimes. Those are positive blood stains, transferred blood stains, or active, means projected from the individual himself who has got injured by means of bullet stepping in the blood. Or transfer means if someone is whipping the blood or pulling the dead body or cleaning any blood weapon used. Passive blood means somewhere it got dropped or it got collected by means of pools. See, this kind of blood spattered can be seen. Active one like this, or the low velocity, you can see this kind of falling of the blood. Or if someone will be assaulted with this rod, and the either it will fall on the ground and also simultaneously on the wall. With high velocity in cases of gunshot, it can take that direction. Drops, it is said exclamatory marks will be obtained if the drop is pretty old. It tells the direction, and spattering, convergence, see where it is converged, the real scene. Neither blood nor anything else travels unaided in a straight line through the air. So various examinations are there to confirm whether it is a blood stains or not by means of the red blood cells. Those are non-nucleated, biconvolucular, concave, biconcave cells for the human, but it is nucleated and oval shape for animals and fish. See, fish will be having this kind of things, bird will be having, mammals will have these, amphibians like this. So sometimes the seminal stains will also be there. You have to detect whether it is seminal stains or not. If it is motile sperms are there, even DNA can be stressed. Here you may be knowing the cuticle is the outermost of the hair coverings. Another inner one is the cortex, and central line the medulla. So you can see the cuticle here, how it is having scales, and the cortex is this much area. Then medulla is nothing but a centrally situated things. So even if the hair, with a hair bulb lying at the scene of crime, can help us to reach to the accused. human hair and animal hair can be differentiated by means of their ratio with the cuticle and the cortex. So you can see the human hair with this kind of scale and the animal's squash hair like this. The medulla will be having major the membrane, that is medulla is not that much proportionate and it is less than the 1/3 human hair and animal hair. You can see the difference how it looks like. So with this we are completing our discussion on the identification point. I again urge you to read the further details what you already learned about race, structure and other anthropometry related, but now tattoos, the superimposition, the scars are also additional features in addition to the anthropometry Bertillon system to know the individualization and the individual characters of the person to know its identification. Medical legal work centrally lies with the identification of the crimes, the victims by means of various trace evidences. We also learnt about the examination of blood men, and this will take us to the criminals and accordingly can be convicted. With this, I urge you to revise the topic, which will tomorrow will be getting further revised in the practical itself. Stay healthy, stay safe, take all the COVID precautions to get infected and to spread further also. It's our all responsibility to break the chain. Take care.